Foldable phones have changed the world completely, altering how we perceive the very framework of a mobile device. This is the evolution of foldable phones, imagined in the early 2010s, available since 2018. No, we're not revisiting the flip phones that charmed us in days past. These are next-level gadgets, screens that fold, yet deliver expansive visuals when needed. They fold into a pocket-friendly size, then unfold for immersive experiences. So hold on tight. We're about to explore a timeline filled with innovation and unexpected turns. Taking you down memory lane, let's revisit the time when foldable phones made their debut.
It's a very, very exciting time. It's really going to be the best time ever. And I'm very excited that Royale is at the leading edge of producing this world of screens.
The FlexPi. The 90s gave us flip phones, but fast forward to October 31st, 2018, and there was a new kid on the block. Royole, a Chinese electronics maestro, unveiled a marvel, the FlexPi. Not just another smartphone, but the world's very first folding phone. By January 2019, the FlexPi was out and about, gracing store shelves. Its unique design? Two 16x9 displays, elegantly joining forces with a hinge. Lay it out flat, and voila, a broad screen lay before you. But there was a twist in the tale. Fold it up, and you had quite a chunky piece of tech, all due to its sizable screen and hardware. And well, let's just say its software wasn't exactly smooth sailing either. Royole's ambitious project was out, but it was clear. Innovation often comes with its set of teething problems. Everyone waited with bated breath.
With the Galaxy Fold, you get a powerful smartphone and a revolutionary tablet, all in a single premium package.
The Galaxy Fold. As the tech world buzzed about Royole's FlexPi, a titan in the industry was silently crafting its masterpiece. Samsung, a household name, was nurturing its vision of the foldable future. At their 2018 annual developer conference, attendees were treated to a sneak peek of what was to come, the Infinity Flex display. Picture this, a phone with a spacious inner screen that folded inwards, revealing a more compact display on the front. Rapid advancements were in play. Samsung, staying true to its commitment, had a special reveal at the Samsung Unpacked event on February 20th, 2019.
We're giving you a device that doesn't just define a new category, it defies category.
Enter the Galaxy Fold. This gadget sported a handy 4.6-inch front screen, perfect for a quick glance at messages or dialing numbers. Yet, its true prowess was evident when you unfurled it. A generous 7.5-inch display emerged, promising richer browsing experiences. However, the sea wasn't all smooth sailing. Although the design left many in awe, its hefty price of $1,980 did raise eyebrows, and that wasn't the only hiccup. The first set of reviewers and media personnel, with their eager hands on early models, faced unforeseen issues.
To each other in a row within minutes are other reviewers with the Galaxy Fold saying, "Hey, my screen broke too. Oh yeah, my screen broke too. Mine too."
Fragile screens and displays falling prey to everyday dust and particles began to paint a grim picture. Images of these compromised units began to circulate, casting a shadow over Samsung's big leap. But if there's one thing to be said about Samsung, it's their knack for resilience and adaptability. They quickly took on these hurdles in stride. Protective plastic films were elongated to snugly fit the display's edges, thus preventing casual peeling. Ingenious T-shaped caps were introduced at both top and bottom ends, safeguarding the screen against intrusive dust and debris. And the coup de grace? A metallic layer fortified the delicate region between the hinge and the mainframe, giving the Galaxy Fold its much-needed durability. After these adjustments, Samsung confidently reintroduced the Galaxy Fold on September 27th, 2019. And, as they say, there's no cloud without a silver lining. The initial challenges did little to dampen the public's fervor.
It's a full wheel display. The 6.6 in the front. I open it. You can see it's the 8-inch. It's a borderless display. You can see there's no notch on this screen.
The Mate X. Huawei, a major tech contender, entered the foldable phone arena with the Mate X, announced on February 24, 2019. Unlike Samsung's Galaxy Fold, which housed its larger screen inside, the Mate X sported a screen that wrapped around its body. Folded, users could access a 6.6-inch display on the front and a 6.38-inch display on the back. Unfolded, it presented an 8-inch screen. Despite its innovative design, the Mate X faced its own set of challenges. Durability concerns led to the delay of its launch. The company worked on refining its design before finally releasing it in China on November 15, 2019. Notably, the device didn't reach the United States market. The 2020. The journey of foldable phones marched forward, showcasing innovations and reshaping mobile experiences. Motorola made a significant splash in the foldable domain with the launch of their Razr. When expanded, this device mirrored the familiar aesthetics of the classic Android phones, but its ability to compact down enhanced its pocket-friendly appeal.
We're changing the shape of the future with the Galaxy Z Flip, as I'd call it, the Z Flip.
On the other hand, Samsung unveiled the Galaxy Z Flip, channeling the presence of Razr's memorable design.
When it's closed, it is a thing of beauty. It's smooth and sleek and symmetrical.
This model surpassed its inspiration by offering superior screen clarity, a more robust battery life, faster performance, all while being lighter on the wallet.
Today, we bring the new product, the upgrade version for this Mate X. It's a Mate XS. It's this product.
Huawei also became intent on updating its foldable phone model. The company followed the Mate X with the Mate XS. It had the same single folding display as the Mate X, but it featured increased durability, faster speeds, and improved cameras.
This year at CES, we showed off a brand new scrollable display concept as well as working rollable smartphone device. There's certainly more that we can share with you.
TCL, not to be outdone, showcased three groundbreaking folding phone prototypes in March 2020. Their standout bifold tablet was a marvel, boasting two distinct folds, unfolding into a trifold display. This innovative design featured an expansive 10-inch screen, which, when folded, transformed into a compact 6-inch phone. Their next offering was truly avant-garde, a rollable-slash-extending foldable device. This piece of tech could gracefully extend, unveiling a sizable display, or be rolled back to resemble the dimensions of a standard smartphone. Lastly, their third prototype took cues from the Galaxy Fold. Mirroring its functionality, this device opened up to a spacious screen, but was designed such that it could easily fold away, fitting snugly into pockets or handbags. In today's technological landscape, foldable phones have truly evolved from their inception with the Galaxy Fold in 2019. The advancements are evident. Batteries last longer, screens are vibrant and sharper, cameras capture life with unparalleled precision, responsiveness is lightning fast. For those who yearn for the nostalgia of compact devices, choices abound. Some models harken back to earlier designs with inner screens measuring between 6 to 7 inches. But if expansive displays are what you're after, there are offerings that spread out, showcasing screens over 8 inches. Gone are the days when a stray splash could spell doom. The new breed of foldables can brave the elements. Take Samsung's Galaxy Z series, for instance. These devices can withstand submersion up to 5 feet for a solid half hour. Compactness is another forte. Consider the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 5. Its ingenious flex hinge design ensures the phone lies perfectly flat when closed. For those willing to invest a tad more, stylus support opens up a realm of possibilities, jotting down notes, leisurely swipes, and so much more. And let's not forget aesthetics. The palette of available colors and materials for these foldable wonders has expanded, offering something for every style and preference. Folding phones bring several benefits to the modern world. For one, they are highly portable. Once folded, they can fit comfortably in purses and wallets. When unfolded, they provide a large screen size that's ideal for browsing the internet, gaming, and multitasking. Foldable phones can transition between phone and tablet, which increases productivity and opens up entertainment possibilities. And let's face it, they are just fun. They are a tech enthusiast's dream. However, foldable phones come with their share of challenges. The chief concern is durability. They are prone to creasing, display failures, and delamination. Most come with factory-installed screen protectors, but they wear out in time. A replacement can cost $30 to $130, depending on your service and warranty. Cost is another concern. The price has gone down a bit since the phones were first released. However, trusted models cost close to $2,000. Cheaper models can be as low as $1,000. The phones require software and app optimization. They have unique form factors and aspect ratios. Software that is not optimized will provide an inferior user experience. Foldable phones also tend to be bulkier and heavier than traditional smartphones, and surely they are not ideal for users who prefer compact designs. So what can we look forward to as folding phones evolve? They are likely to become more durable and more affordable. Users should see new designs that vary from traditional foldout and clamshell styles. They may integrate with more technology, including wearable technology that enhances the user experience. We may also see larger displays that are conducive to creativity, productivity, and design. We've reached the end of our episode about evolution of foldable phones. I'm John, and I've enjoyed showing you around this interesting topic. Looking for more? We have other topics coming up, so keep watching. If you like learning about evolutions of devices, think about subscribing. It's free and helps a lot. Thanks for being here.